Hi, Jeff.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for being here.
You've made some feature films. You've made some great TV shows like One Piece and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. But there's any dream project or any filmmaker that you would like to work with?
Thank you. I appreciate that. I'm a big movie nerd. So my list of directors is that I would kill to work with is long, but I love the Coen brothers. I'm such big fans of them. Obviously they're making stuff separately now, but I love them. Paul Thomas Anderson is also one of my favorites. Scorsese would be pretty incredible to work with, that little known director. I'm working on directing a movie myself that I'm trying to get, hopefully is happening next year. So there's so many aspects that I have fallen in love with behind the camera too. And I directed a play last year in New York City, and it really gave me, I caught the bug for wanting to direct. So I'm a bit weird because I like acting, I like writing, I like directing. So like I kind of like to float between all of them. But I kind of have my eye on directing this movie that I co-wrote next year. And besides that, if you know the Coen brothers, or Paul Thomas Anderson, or Martin Scorsese, please send them my way, because I'd love to work with them. And I also forgot to say all of my favorite Guillermo del Toro, and Cuarón, and Almodovar, like all the incredible Latino filmmakers that I really admire and have such a... Iñárritu is one of the best around. I want to work with those guys too.
The comic book had such an incredible character that when I read the comic, I was immediately I liked him so much, and I thought he was he was so funny but also so dangerous and interesting, and had this relationship with Luffy that I thought was really cool and complicated. And when we were filming the first season, there was some information that came out about Shanks and Buggy when they were young. And Matt Owens, the showrunner, and I, we talked a lot about that, and because we wanted that to kind of be there from the beginning. So I was very excited to kind of have this character that felt like such a heightened version of a real person underneath, that was kind of just like a bullied kid that got superpowers and became an asshole. But a funny asshole. So to answer your question, I really wanted to play a funny asshole.
Anime fans are very intense. and there's been so many... It's such a hard medium to translate into live action. I think that a lot of the live action adaptations have proven. And the anime community will let you know about it if they don't like what you did. Like I said, as soon as I read the comic, I loved him so much, and I felt like I understood him in a way of how I would want to portray him. So I kind of just tried to focus on that. And then right before it came out, I was like, are people going to hate this? Because I was doing a lot of screaming and yelling. And I hope people don't hate it. But I kind of tried to let that go while I was doing it, and then after that, later, it was definitely, but it seemed like people liked what we did, and that was very gratifying and exciting because it was such a high wire act to get that right, especially because One Piece is so beloved by so many people. And I tried not to think about it while I was doing it, and then just sort of the night before it came out, was like, I don't know, I hope people don't want to kill me for this, but yeah, so it was lucky.